In this video, you'll discover all the ways that you can boost your immune system by using targeted nutrition. Over the past couple months, we've been dealing with a few things. One of them's been influenza and the other one's been coronavirus. Neither of them need any introduction because I'm sure you're familiar with them. But what does need some more explaining is ways that you can boost your immune system naturally using targeted nutrition. And so that's what we're gonna discover in this video. So stick around to the end as I break down the top things that you can do and all the science behind it. Stick around to the end. But before we get started, I'm Dr. Zyrowski and welcome to the channel. If you're new to the channel, it's a pleasure to have you here. Be sure to subscribe, hit that notification bell and join our notification community, and I'm going to help you excel your health and your life. Now, before I get started, one of the things I want to say, I think it's an absolute travesty that we don't hear anything on how we can actually boost our immune system naturally using science-based nutrition in order to actually skyrocket immune health to protect us from any oncoming viral threat. It's an absolute travesty that we don't hear about it in the media. We don't hear about it in any way. All we hear about is the next vaccine, the next medication, but we don't hear about the natural ways. And many people are actually immune depressed. And as a result, when these different viruses hit them, it is really devastating to their body. So let's talk about the ways that you can start boosting your immune system up today. First on our list is we're going to talk about NAC. Now, if you're not familiar with NAC, NAC is basically an amino acid. It stands for N-acetylcysteine. Research shows that it has many powerful benefits to offer the body. First thing it can do here is it helps decrease inflammation. It helps decrease inflammation because it's a precursor to one of the most powerful antioxidants in the body, glutathione. And so as it decreases inflammation, that's very powerful because one of the things that comes along with these viral attacks is an inflammatory response that in many cases gets out of control when we have a depressed immune system. So it's going to help decrease inflammation. It also has been shown in the science to decrease respiratory attacks. Why is this so important now more than ever? Simply because the coronavirus attacks the lungs. When we look at the people who are dying from the coronavirus, they're dying from acute respiratory distress syndrome. And typically, when they have this issue, they are not able to breathe, and then that is what they eventually die from. So what we want to do here is make sure that we support the lungs. So what is out there better to do it than using some N-acetylcysteine? Now, the other thing it's going to do is help stop viral replication. Okay, these viruses just keep replicating in our body. If we want to get better, we have to stop the replication. NAC has been shown to do that in the science. And also, it increases natural killer cells, a special type of white blood cell that goes in and kills different antigens, different invaders in the body. So that's really powerful as well. So NAC is really awesome. Let's talk about zinc here, because zinc is also something that we hear nothing about, and it's so important for your immune system. And this is a mineral. This is the second most important mineral to the body, because iron's the first most abundant mineral in the body. Zinc is second. And a lot of people are actually deficient in this. And so when we look at zinc, it's been shown in the research to help decrease infection risk in elderly. Now, I mean, we couldn't have something more important than this information right here. Who's getting the coronavirus and having a devastating impact from it? In fact, who gets the influenza and has a devastating impact from it? The elderly. And so we want to make sure that we use zinc in order to help get this benefit, according to the research. Zinc has also been shown to help decrease the common cold by 33%. That's a huge number. It also has been shown to decrease infection time. So if you get the influenza, coronavirus, if you get a viral attack on the body, it's been shown to actually help decrease the infection time. It helps fight the viruses and, of course, shut down that replication, just like NAC does. So zinc is also very powerful and very important when it comes to boosting your immune system. Now, on our list next is vitamin D. Vitamin D is one that most people are familiar with, is pretty important for our overall health. A lot of people don't know why it's so important, but one of the reasons is because it plays such a critical role in your overall immune health. It actually activates AMPKs. These are a special type of cell that really help go in and kill off the different foreign invaders in the body. It activates those AMPKs. It also helps modulate inflammation, which is important. As I mentioned, sometimes with these different attacks on the body, these viral attacks, bacterial infections, whatever it may be, Sometimes the inflammatory response is a little bit overzealous and it can go in and be very damaging to the body. If you look at, for instance, coronavirus, one of the things that happens is when it hits the lungs and it sends that storm of inflammation, it does damage that actually can last a long period of time. And so we want to make sure that we're able to modulate inflammation properly. Now, there's a study in Norway on vitamin D. It was pretty interesting because what they did is there was a group of doctors that went and took their patients and they looked at them and they said, well, vitamin D deficient people versus those who have sufficient levels of vitamin D. Those who were deficient in vitamin D actually were more likely to get influenza and pneumonia versus those who had sufficient levels of vitamin D. Now, it's very important to make sure that you have good levels of vitamin D. You should get these checked if you have not. And also, if you're someone who is an African American, if you're someone who is Hispanic, you are more likely to have a deficiency, okay? This is very important because if you are more likely to have a deficiency in vitamin D, then you are also more likely to have a compromised immune system. So nobody may have told you that, but it's something that's absolutely critical to know. Vitamin C is next on our list. Now, vitamin C is one I often refer to as a little bit overhyped. Most people, when they hear about getting sick or they think that there's potential they might get sick, they typically know to go take vitamin C and they typically take tons of it, but they leave out all this other good stuff, you know? So we look at vitamin C, we have to realize it is very beneficial, but it's not the only thing we should be doing here. Now, vitamin C is a powerful antioxidant. Why is that really good? Because at this time, we want to make sure that we're fighting oxidative stress to decrease inflammation. Vitamin C will help with that. It also has been shown in the research to give an improved immune response, improved immune function, and also shorten the duration in which you are sick. So if you get hit with the influenza, vitamin C can help shorten the duration in the time in which you're sick. So vitamin C is something that is great to have in the mix here. Now, last on our list, and certainly not by any means least, is going to be garlic. Now, garlic is something I love. I actually like the taste of it, but also I love the benefits it has on your overall health and immune function. It's a powerful antioxidant, and it's been shown to actually help decrease the common cold by 63%. They did this study. They had some individuals take garlic, individuals that were sick with the common cold, and then another group who did not use garlic. The group that actually was using the garlic, they were able to decrease the common cold by 63%. That's huge. And so garlic is really powerful when it comes to fighting off bacteria, viruses, the whole deal. Now, garlic has also been shown to decrease the common cold symptoms by 70%. There was another study, same thing. One group took garlic, the other group didn't. The group that actually took garlic were able to cut down the symptoms from 5 days to 1.5 days, where those who were not using garlic, they were getting symptoms for 5 days. So it's incredibly powerful stuff. Now, I also want to tell you now, if you want to actually learn more about how to boost your immune system naturally, be sure to check out this playlist right up here, because I'll link up all of the different videos, but also remember that this is actually part two of a multiple part series on how to boost your immune system naturally. I teach you everything you need to know on how to do this. There's not a more important time to understand this information. And it's very important to understand when we look at all these people who are getting sick, we have to realize that we live in a society of people who are very immune compromised. And so utilize these different nutritional components here, these different nutrients. And what I'll do is I'll put a link in the description below. There's this company called Celerity Health that makes this really cool kit that actually has all of these in it. You take this kit for a short period of time whenever you're sick or whenever you're trying to fight something or prevent illness or anything like that. And they have these packets that have all these nutrients in it. And I love it. And it's something that I actually use in my own home. So I'll put a link to that in the description below. And I also will put links in the description below to more information on all these topics. I do a video on each one of them, breaking them down a little bit further, diving into the research a little bit more. So check all that out. This is just a starting conversation, but check out this whole immune series and all the information surrounding it. Give this video a thumbs up and then go to this video right here to learn more about immune health. White blood cells that are spared, they remember that foreign invader. The immune system knows it's coming. It knows what it is. It knows how to react. It knows how to kill it. And it acts very fast.